Very good day. I was just about to record this video and realised that, in fact, I'd done kind of this video about 8 weeks ago. I think I said three antennas that you should, you know, build or whatever. But I actually think there's four, but and then five if we include the off-centre fed dipole, which I think we'll make a separate video about. So the spin on this one is, let's have a look at these antennas, the vertical, the loop, the dipole particularly, how they multiband, and some of the mechanics and engineering, or what wire do we use, how do we hold these things up? Because I think that's very interesting. Most of us can understand, you know, how to put a dipole up, but give me some ideas about what fits together, how, what cord to use, you know, things like that. So, well, we'll start with the ground-mounted vertical. I think it'd be a good idea. I'm just making sure you can see my stuff here. And I, how many times have I done this? I don't know. But let's take a 40 meter band. This is going to be about, well, just under 10 meters long with velocity factor. 10 meters long. And by the way, you could have a tree here, right? So let's just take the bottom of a tree. Oh, there's a green. So the underhand of a tree, you know, whatever. You could just hang this straight down, and your coax would come along. We would put the braid of the coax, scatter a few radials around. How many? I don't know. Say 16 radials at about 20 foot each would be great. Half that. Cut them shorter. It doesn't really matter. It's an experiment, you know. And you put the center conductor of the coax straight up the pole. You'll find that's got quite a huge bandwidth. But at the end of the day, no doubt you'll have a bit of a fold over at the top. Little one here. Fold over the top with a halyard, you know, so you can raise it up and down. Put a brick or something on the coax just to stop it floating around. And to connect to your terminal, to connect to the braid, use a brass earthing block. Works a treat. You could fit at least, you know, 30 or 40 radials into 8 holes, you know. So that would work really well. Smother it with a bit of Vaseline. You don't need to go to any extent with silicon grease and all that stuff. If you wanted to keep it nice, you know, any wire at all, doesn't really matter. If you put it under terrible tension, and it's not hard-drawn copper wire or Kevlar wire or something, you might find it'll stretch a bit, but whatever. So we'll just talk about this fold-over, actually, at the top here, where it comes up and then back down again. In the main, and I'll make a specific video about this, but in the main, if you've got... let's concentrate. Let's make this fold-over even bigger. There we are, because it'll be a bit easier. Let's say that fold over is either 1 foot or 30 centimetres, because they're both about the same. 1 foot fold over or 30 centimetres fold back is the equivalent of, 1 foot is 12 inches, the equivalent of 4 inches going that way, right? Or 10 centimetres going this way. It's about 3 to 1 at the end, right? There's a whole thing. If you linear load an element, you've got more loading down here. So it's more like 5 to 1, 6 to 1 down at the bottom. But, you know, for the top third, it'll be that. In fact, if you make this 9.1, 9.2 meters long and come back down 2 meters, about 6 feet. Yeah, use Google, convert 9.12 meters, 2 feet. All right, 2 feet. 9.2 up, 2 meters back, you'll get a tune on 40 and 15, as it happens. So that's a vertical. And of course, remember from the video I did about how I designed, or how I didn't invent DX Commander, at the feed point there, you could always put another one up for 20 meters. You could have a little 20 meter then off the same, you know, so at the feed point, right at the feed point, there's your 40 meter element. Just, I don't know, put a bit of wood or something, little hole, and bring up your 20 meters. Try not to get it to wobble around, because otherwise, once you've tuned it and it starts wobbling, SWR is gonna muck around. How does that compare, by the way, with... So there's a vertical. I'm running ahead of myself. Great for DX. A lot of people go, oh, but they're a lot noisier. Yeah, well, they're not really a lot noisier. What they're actually doing is picking up low to the ground receive. They're doing the job they were designed for, all right? That's one of the reasons, anyway. Have a little loop on the ground. Have a little low to the ground dipole to switch between the two if you want to receive nicely. But you'll be transmitting. Don't ever think that, oh, listen to my vertical, it's crap. You know, it wasn't until, what was his call sign? Stan. I forget his call sign. One field day. 3 a.m, he's on 40 metres chatting to this guy. Yeah, on field day. And he said, I just want to flick over to the vertical because he didn't believe it was as hot, basically. He flicked over to the vertical, gave the guy, you know, an over. And the fellow said, you've now come up 2 S-points on your transmit. It's very difficult to gauge if an antenna is transmitting better or not, unless you get a live confirmation. Because if you're only gauging it on receive, you might be very wrong. You would have thought at my age I might be able to shave without bleeding. So if you see blood on my face, I haven't been fighting. So there's a vertical. What can I say? Any old wire will do, insulated or not. By the way, this fold over that I'm talking about here is with insulated wire, because if you come back down and touch it and it's uninsulated, it will just look like it's this long. Okay? You don't want it like that. Insulated wire will do this whole foldy overy thing. Yeah. Dipoles. Both a dipole and a vertical resonate every third harmonic. So a harmonic off your radio will be 7 megahertz, 14, 21, 28, okay? So if you've got something that's resonant on 7 megahertz, it will again be resonant somewhere around 21. Actually a little bit higher, there's all sorts of reasons for that. But this foldover will give you a 40 and a 15, and then one up the side, as we were talking about earlier on, will give you 20. So there's 40, 20 and 15. And how much does that cost you? A bit of coax out into the backyard, garden. So dipoles doing the same. If we build one for 40 metres, I'll make an inverted V, all right? We'll make a tree again. Doesn't have to be a tree, obviously. Anything you've got knocking around here. My first few antennas were made of supports, were made of wood. Banister rails, just screwed them into the fence posts. I had wooden fence posts at the time. So this is going to be roughly the same size as this one, each leg of this one here. So again, you're looking at about, probably, you could start off with 9.5 metres. By the way, let me just search how long to convert. I'll show you. Convert 9.5 metres to feet, just in case. 31-ish feet, right? That's what it says. 9.5 both ways. Again, you could use a little loop at the end, and a bit of paracord off to something. Doesn't matter if one leg's lower than the other. It doesn't matter. Looking down on the top now, you've got your tree, and here's your dipole. We're looking down on it. I drew the dipole in blue, so keep the OCD people happy. There's our dipole. It won't quite fit in. It doesn't matter if you do this, or do that, or come down and along a bit. It doesn't matter, okay? The coax goes to the middle. So the braid, you know, your coax comes up, the braid's going to go one side and the centre conductor's going to go the other. You can buy fancy little connectors for that. My first few antennas, I didn't use anything. I just had a bit of coax going out there. I just wanted to go, oh my God, it works. Fantastic. So as a dipole, you can multiband this, of course. We could turn this into a fan dipole. So this, if you do the same trick, go about 9.2 one way and then back 2 meters, about 6 feet. So in other words, that's going to be 31 feet one way and about 6 feet the other. You'll then get a tune on 40 and 15. All right. So if you wanted 20 as well, all you do is you put another set of elements. Easier said than done, because they're going all over the place. What I did is I put a weight. Hopefully you can see this. I put a weight here at the end, and then a bit of paracord about to there. And that, it would fly around in the wind a wee bit, and that's fine. In fact, I did that. I made mine 80, 40, and then I put a 20 in, as it so happens, which I'll do in blue. All right, there's my 20. And again, another little weight. And then a bit of paracord off. It looked good. I'll try and find a picture of that and put it on the screen. So you can multi-band a dipole as well. You know, you've got some old Cat 5 knocking around, or some electrical things, some contractors left knocking around. Oh, make an antenna out of it. So my house, when I first became amateur radio guy, my house is a funny shape. The back of the house was here. This is my garden on the around the outside. I had this, as I say, this sort of fence post thing here, that I put banister rails, 16 feet, what's that, 4 meters or something, banister rails here, and I made a 40 meter loop. I couldn't quite squeeze it in, so I put a couple of little eyelets, and the wire itself went basically like this. And I had to muck around, to be honest, a little bit just to get the right size so that it tuned on 40. Hang on, though. That will need a 4-to-1 ballon here. And I ran some coax up through here and into the attic and out on the eaves, you know, and that was fine. I had these on halyards because I came up with a rather brilliant idea that to get on 80, maybe I could just cut a piece out completely and replace that with paracord. So this red bit became an optional paracord. And sure enough, I was getting a really good tune, even with the 4-to-1 ballon, on 80 metres. It was a hell of a funny shape. It was like a kind of a halo square triangle. I was getting out. I was making contacts as well. I was 10 watts at the time. Then to get, and these were on halyards. These posts, I had this on little halyards that would hold this up. And at night, I would literally go outside with the flashlight, the torch, as we say in the UK, and I would crocodile clip the two together. Short it out, and I'd be back on 40 metres. And that gave me 40 and 80 with the crocodile clips. And a loop, unlike a dipole, will resonate on every harmonic. So 40, and I was getting, let's do it in red, keep me really happy. 40, I was getting 30, no, it wasn't. 40, 20, 15, and 10. That's perfectly resonant because it's every, this is resonant on every harmonic. So 7.1 becomes 14.2, becomes 21.3, becomes 28.4, a loop. Now, in a modern world, a lot of people are after fantastic gain and everything else. Even on pathetic gain, a big station is going to hear you, right? If the propagation's in, if you've got a bit of a roadway. But for a Saturday morning or Saturday afternoon, loafing around on 40 metres, work to treat. And I'll model this one day, not today, but 20 metres. There was some gain here and there, because I didn't have it very, well, 16 feet. And I think about 20 feet here, you know. So that's a really interesting, cheap way, right? And I had some literally second-hand wire given to me, you know. Now, the other thing is, and I haven't used one, so I feel a bit of a cheat that I can't tell you about this, but we've got the end fed as well. So the end fed is generally a box of tricks with a transformer that you attach your coax to one end, and you have a terminal, and you'll put a lot, half a wave, right? The end fed half wave. They call it like that, end fed half wave. You might have seen that around. So the 40 meter band, that's 20 meters long. It's about 60 feet or so. So that, and that would give you all the harmonics, I seem to remember. I think, you correct me in the comments, if you look in the comments to make sure I've got this right, but that would give, so if that was 20 metres, 60-ish feet, that would then give you 40, 20, I think 15 and 10. Of course, if you double the length to 40 metres, there's a hell of a length that, by the way, that would give you 80 as well, if it was 40 metres long. End-fed half-wave. So for the 20-metre bands, not so bad, because you could use a 10-metre pole. 10-metre pole here, here's your ground. Coax coming up to a little box. And then 10-metre wire up the top. You could tune it with this fold-over business. Again, you know, just to get it right. And you can get 20. I think you get 20 and 10 on that. Let me know in the comments. I'm also interested what... I mean, I'll just run through some of the wire I've used. Okay, so old telephone wire, the pairs that you can split. You could make a little device with a couple of holes in it, put it through with a razor blade, pull it, and they'll all come apart. And that was solid copper. And that used to work great. And I think that was even hard-drawn copper wire. I've used garden fence wire. I've used heavy electrical wire. That was a bit too heavy because the insulation is quite heavy. All sorts of stuff. If you use some weird wire, I'm fascinated. I want to hear about it, so in another video I can give people examples, you know. So that's the end-fed. And then the only other one we haven't done, and to be honest, I think I did a off-center fed dipole search earlier on, and I think it'd be a good idea for me to look at that. I did some modelling, not quite off-center fed, but I did some modelling and I got an 80 and a 40. So there's a multi-band potential. Go and look it up, off-center fed dipole, but you're getting some really weird patterns further up. That's the only thing I would say. You're not getting, at least the dipole, you know that you're going, if it's quite a high up dipole, you know that your bananas, right, are going left and right, let's say. But with some of these off-center fed things, you're getting lows and deep nulls and all sorts. Even on 40 metres, I did some quick modelling earlier on. I'm not yet ready to do that, but I would have a look at the off-center fed dipole. You can just buy these, you know. Seems a bit of a shame, because if you've got a 4-to-1 ballon and you just had the dimensions, you know, because you should have a 4-to-1 ballon so you can try things like this, because that's good fun. And when you've had your use out of the 4-to-1 ballon, try this loop really low down in the ground. It's fence height. I remember listening to a guy on 80 metres one evening, and he had a loop going round his fence at 6 feet, 2 metres off the ground. He was running a pile-up. People couldn't believe that he was so strong. I don't think he could either. And by the way, when it's that low, it won't be 80 metres all the way around. It'll be 10% off that. Because as an antenna gets closer to the ground, it can become smaller because of the capacitance on the ground, a few other things. But I've never done, really try. It's quite difficult to do tables and graphs like that. Might be in the ARRL handbook. If anybody knows what the answer, height above ground for a dipole or a loop, I'd be fascinated if there's a link or, you know, if there's a book in it or something like that. So any old paracord will do, you know, a bit of shock cord maybe, a 4-to-1 ballon, a choke if you must, or a dirty ballon. You know what a dirty ballon is. It's one of these things, look. Dirty ballon images. So if you're really stuck, I mean, there is, you know, a dirty ballon, right? Nice little former, bit of coax around it. You can get yourself really, or an ugly ballon, some people have called it. By the way, you can get yourself really hung up on chokes, really hung up on chokes. So if you're not getting a problem and you have intentionally built something that is supposed to be resonant on that band, chances are you won't be getting much common mode current coming back. You might be. Just be aware of it. In other words, if your mouse starts playing up or somebody says your audio is sounding funny, you'll know the reason. I've probably waffled on long enough. Oh, heavens. It says here, I'll cut this down. It's probably going to be about 15 minutes. Sorry about that. Okay. Right. Next video is coming up here. I will see you on the next one. Bye for now. It says 20 minutes. Look.